Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 13.4.1 to the public. This brings some bug fixes and things to not only iPhone, but also iPad as well, and supports all iOS 13 supported devices. So anything from iPhone 7, 6S, SE, all of those are all supported, as well as iPad Air 2 and newer. Now, the first thing is the size. This came in at 95.4 megabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro. I also installed it on my 12.9 2020 iPad Pro, iPhone 8 Plus, and iPhone 11, and it was all about the same size. Now, if you are on iOS 13.4.5 beta, Apple has not released a public beta yet. Maybe they will later today or by the time you're watching this, but as of this video, they haven't released it. And also, keep in mind you won't get this update if you're on that beta because this is actually older than that beta. So this does include a few fixes, but first, let's take a look at the build number. The build number is 17E262, and this particular build includes a few fixes like I mentioned. And the first thing is there's no modem update to any of these devices that I could find. Some people have said differently, but on all of these devices, there's no modem update. Also, there's no fix for mail mentioned at all. So if you were having issues with that, it hasn't been fixed. Hopefully it has, and they just haven't mentioned it, but as far as what they've told us, there is no fix for that. Now, the first thing Apple fixed is an issue where people were placing FaceTime calls with iOS 13.4 and could not FaceTime call people with older devices running iOS 9.3.6 and earlier, or also macOS El Capitan 10.11.6 and earlier. So they've fixed that with this particular update. There has not been an update for iOS 9.3.6 that I've seen. So it seems like it was on the iOS 13.4 side and they fixed it here. Now the other setting that they've fixed or the other issue that they've fixed has to do with Bluetooth. So where you would 3D press or haptic press and go to Bluetooth, it now works properly. And again, if I swipe settings off the phone, do it again, it works fine every time. So they've fixed that issue. I know that was a big issue for a lot of people and they've since fixed that. Now, other than the issues I already mentioned where they fixed those on the iPhones, the same fixes apply to iPadOS or any of the recent iPads. However, there was a bug with the 2020 iPads Pro. So for example, this is the 2020 12.9 inch iPad Pro. And with these iPads, they have a flashlight and Apple has fixed where it may not work when you go to the control center and turn on the flashlight, or you do that from the lock screen. On the 2020 iPad 12.9 and 11 inch, this may have been a problem and they've since fixed it. So that's been updated and there are no more updates, including security updates. That's really all this is a bug fix, unless they didn't tell us about something else that they actually repaired. Now, as far as a couple apps that were updated for the iPad, Apple's Clips app has been updated. So this app is updated with new stickers and things and also supports trackpad and mouse support from 13.4. So we have all of that latest support with Clips. Also, Pixelmator Photo has been updated with trackpad and mouse and keyboard support from 13.4. So it has all of those new features, and it's something that I use regularly to edit photos and things, mostly on the Mac, but it's more useful now on the iPad that you have external controls. So all of those things have been updated. Now, as far as battery life on this, well, it will take a few days to know what it's like for sure, but I've been running iOS 13.4.5 betas on the iPhone 11 Pro Max, and it's been doing really well. So if we go into settings, assuming that Apple has used the same sort of changes or fixes in this that they have on 13.4.1, you can expect some pretty decent battery life. In fact, this was yesterday. I had 4 hours and 6 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 5 minutes of screen off time. And you'll see day over day, it just seems to be really good. I got 5 hours and 25 minutes one day, and I'm using about 50% of the battery depending on the day. And it's really holding out well. So that means I'll easily hit 10 to 12 hours of screen on time and maybe 1 to 4 hours of screen off time, playing music and things like that. So only a few days will tell. Of course, I'll do a follow-up and talk about that a little bit later. As far as in the week, I normally do a community poll and things like that. Now, as far as performance, well, this is the iPhone 11. I have it on all of these devices here, but performance overall seems to be pretty fast. Scrolling and everything is smooth. It takes a moment for things to load just like normal. And then on maybe something a little bit older, which isn't that old, but an iPhone 8 Plus, it seems to be holding up well also. So Again, the same thing is fast. RAM management is pretty good in iOS 13.4.5, so I would expect the same here. But again, that will take a few days to know. Generally, I'll open 20 apps and it will run fine for the first 5 minutes, so we'll see if that continues to happen. But again, I'll do a follow-up a little bit later when we'll talk about that. Now let's take a look at the benchmarks. Now I use Geekbench 5 on this, so let's go into Geekbench, and you'll see I scored 1,336 and 3,442 for multi-core score. This is actually quite good compared to the previous version. Let's take a look at the history, and I ran this right before I installed it, and you'll see on the new one, we have a higher single core, but a lower multi-core score. So the scores are very close, and generally when they're about the same, this is what I'm seeing from other people as well, when they're about the same, you're going to see basically the same performance. Now let's take a look at the Geekbench scores on all of these devices. Now on the left, we have the 12.9 iPad Pro from 2020, then the iPhone 8 Plus, then the iPhone 11, and then the iPhone 11 Pro. And these scores probably will go up a little bit after a few hours to a day, just because there's a lot of background activity going on that needs to complete. So that's it for iOS 13.4.1. It was kind of surprising to see that they released this, even though a week ago they released iOS 13.4.5 Beta 1 and skipped 1 through 4. So maybe we'll see them fill those in, but maybe not. It's really hard to say, but I'm looking more forward to iOS 14, where we'll see new features and things like that in June as far as the betas, and then a final release in September if the timeline is the same this year. It could be pushed back a little bit, but it's hard to say. But iOS 13.4.5 may release when iPhone SE does, which is expected on the 14th. So maybe we'll see that, maybe we won't. And this is just a minor bug fix update to fix all of the little things and hopefully make it much more stable and give you much better battery life in general. But let me know how it's going for you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.